I'm gonna be a total bitch and I'm gonna get rid of who I have to get rid of and I'm gonna hurt people's feelings and I'm gonna laugh when people cry and I'm gonna own it.
Oh, Bob, he's just like the forever Boy Scout.
Go, Bob! Go, Bob! Let's just give him some moral support.
Bob, he's totally like, he gets it together. He's got the camp running really smoothly.
Yeah, it's looking really good, man.
He's 57 years old and he's awesome.
Originally when I came in, I really liked Jackie and I really liked Marcus and also Charlie, because I feel like they're really trustworthy. I know that that's only four and that leaves five out, but that's a short-term thing. And then we just need a peripheral one extra person to be in the majority, and Bob is really benign, like everyone likes him.
So Marcus and Jackie always go off together and have become the couple of our tribe, which is a problem because anytime you are in a romantic involvement with somebody else, it puts a target on your back. I have no intention of staying with them if they continue this behavior. It's just not, it's bad business. I think Bob responds really well to bold, confident moves. When I was speaking to him, I had to speak to him like, here's the deal, these are the four, you're the fifth, that's all you need to know, it's the majority, we're getting rid of this one. That's it. And it doesn't really matter, because we're five.
Yep.
So, lock it down. That's it.
Good point.
None of us are looking to take Bob to the end. However, we need him for numbers, and I think that we can trust him.
Having Bob around is definitely an asset, but I'm not looking to take him to the end.
I think Sugar on Exile Island is doing about as bad as anybody can be doing on Exile. She is so, like, clutching her knees, rocking back and forth, hysterically crying. She has an attempted look for the idol. She's probably this close from a complete meltdown, if not already in the throes of a meltdown. I really can't stand Ace. I'm not sure that that accent is real. I think he's a con artist. I'd like to see him go home sooner rather than later. I'm afraid that if Ace goes with us to the merge, that he'll be the first to flip because he's on the outskirts of our alliance. Getting rid of Paloma, whatever, that can be done later. You want to get rid of Ace earlier before he gains momentum, before we merge. That's more important.
I don't know. It's hard to say. I dislike so many people on this damn tribe that it's like, it's a toss-up.
It doesn't matter if you weigh 100 pounds more than me, you still get the same, like, proportion of food. But Dan decided that he deserves fourth and fifth servings of food.
Have the salt.
So now we are going through food at an alarming rate, and he takes multiple servings. I'm sick about how much food is being wasted on him. Ugh. If it wasn't for Dan, we wouldn't have rationing laws. So when the pastries came back, like, the old CODA members, like me, Marcus, and Charlie, are all already like, how are we gonna divide this? So we try and make it as fair as possible. I would say that Dan is socially inept in a lot of ways. I don't know if he's a former fatty or why he wasn't liked as a child, but deep down inside, he's a little kid that's seeking approval. Dan had been cutting up the habanero pepper. Dan is very abrasive with the way he does things. He was like, I know how to cut these up, da 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 da. So he grabbed them real quick and like went over to cut them up and was like taking the seeds out and doing all this stuff. And the whole time, Susie, who's Mexican, who probably grew those in her backyard, was like, they're very spicy, they're very hot, you shouldn't really handle them. So he cuts them up and he gets the oils all over his hands and he goes to wipe his eye and it's like he's got pepper spray in his eye. And he is now like full on, like can't see, can't breathe, is crying. It looked to be a horrible state of affairs, which all I could do not to laugh. You know, what are we gonna do other than stare? He's just a mess, he's a hot mess. We knew we were gonna get some sandwiches, but that's all we knew. Lettuce.
Chocolate.
Turns out it was a very involved picnic. This was not your average like schmo picnic.
What about this?
Those are gherkins.
Oh, pickles are, those will last.
Yeah, I'd like to have those one of those. I'd like.
They're passing around things like gherkins, really simple, small pickles. Nobody knows, what are these? Are these African?
This smells like cat food.
It's pate.
We use it steak bake for the catfish.
No.
I don't care.
It's expensive, we do not do that. Who doesn't know what pate is? Prosciutto, what is blue cheese? I mean, these are not non-American or foreign things. It was maddening. It becomes less enjoyable when you have to worry about divvying everything up because everybody's always conscious of, is he getting more?
Randy's sucking it down.
Unfortunately, you get these great experiences, but you have to share them with people you can't stand. I'd rather be serving up poison to these people.
So this moron has decided that she'd like me to go.
Really? I hate her. I hate her, hate her, hate her. I'm like, I really want to stab her in the face. And if you piss me off, you've pissed off my alliance. Prior to going in, Susie told me that she was going to vote for me based on the fact that she did not think I did enough work around camp. Well, then we get to tribal. Who's the weakest player in the game? I think Corinne's weaker than me. I think I swim better than Corinne. I think I have better upper body strength. The woman is 47 years old. What could she possibly have over me?
After what Susan said at last night's tribal, I plan on burying her as soon as possible, alive. I am an extremely vindictive person, and I will get my revenge.
If I were to vote tomorrow, I would vote for Maddie. He doesn't have a hidden immunity idol, and he's too much of a threat for me in individual immunity, and he's threatening to Marcus, and Marcus is my alliance. So he will go home as soon as we vote. I was very pleased with a conversation I had with Randy this morning just regarding Maddie, because we need to get rid of him first if we have to go to tribal, and like he totally is on board. 100%. So we got your email this morning, but I was really hoping that it was going to be Merge, something Merge-esque, because I want to see Marcus again. Randy, I can't hold it that much longer.
That's not bad.
That's great.
The Coda Alliance from the get-go was me, Charlie, and Marcus. As long as that's intact, I don't really care who goes home. I could not believe they had gotten rid of Marcus. It was so heartbreaking just because that really damages my chances at the game. All we're thinking is food. But instead, they start beating us with leaves that are covered in water and like stripping our clothes off of us to wash us down. Like you felt like a human being again. It was nice. It was really nice. And then we went to the next tribal ceremony, and this little girl, she was very, very cute. She was like too small to like follow everybody and like hang out, so I paid some attention to her, and then she was like lewd to me, which was cute. But I'd be the last person anyone would think would like chum up to a 2-year-old. My whole plan is just to stay on Sugar, because she is the swing vote. Not only do I have to act interested in what Sugar's saying, but I have to act like I care about her. Sugar is so weak and naive and gullible. I've been nasty to her for 25 days. I was nice to her one day, and she's sold. So it doesn't even make sense, but she buys it, because she's such a moron. I'm gonna do whatever I think I can do when I wake up tomorrow morning. I'm gonna reevaluate the situation and hope to come out with something. I mean, Kenny and Crystal are taking out my entire alliance. My chances are very slim. You know, most likely, me, Bob, and Randy, we're gonna go home, and we don't know in what order, but we're gonna go home. So this morning I'm in the hut and Sugar decides that she's gonna teach me a lesson about life from a girl who is, I'm sorry, a non-college graduate waitress who's out of work. She doesn't even have a waitress job. She lives off the kindness of others. I don't like people that live off the kindness of others. There is no honor in that. At the very least, I have the jury. We'll give the million to who we want to give the million to, and trust that won't be Sugar. I don't know who it'll be, but it won't be Sugar. So her little teaching me a lesson, really, this is how the lesson goes, bitch. I don't know if I'm gonna spend a dime in the auction unless I get something that is going to help me stay in this game. I mean, that is worth every penny of $500. Nothing tastes better than $500, except a million. Randy and I needed to win. Now I'm going on a wing and a prayer that Bob has the idol. I just need to figure out if he has it or not. I was so close.
In general, I'm a nice person to people I like. I am now in a camp of mutants, none of whom I like, so it's very difficult for me to pretend to be nice to them. That's not something I'm used to, and that's done.
When they started to pick, and Crystal immediately picked Sugar, I realized right away they're all about, you know, sticking together, and it sucks. You know, I don't want to go home, and I don't know, you know, what to do to save myself. Seeing my brother, and seeing somebody who loves me and who knows me and who gets my sense of humor and who knows how mean I am and loves it was such a cool, like, just, I was overcome with emotion. Having my brother as a new face come in to camp and being able to tell him all the things on my mind and have him, you know, understand where I'm coming from was awesome. I'm around people 24 hours a day that I can't stand. So when I got my brother alone and I was dishing out to him, I mean, I was on the floor laughing with my brother because he totally gets it. Obviously, Bob and I know that our numbers are up. So we've got this whole backstory about why we have the idol that was supposedly launched into the ocean at the fake-out feast. But what we needed to have this work correctly was at least one of us to get the immunity idol, which is exactly what happened. I think I'm very smart, and I think Bob is very crafty, and we put those two forces together. This was the best we could do. It would be so awesome if this worked. We come up with a ridiculously harebrained scheme that shouldn't work at all, and it might actually work, which is so mind-blowing. It just shows you the level of like incompetence that we're playing with.
I've always been the kind of person that says exactly what's on my mind and operates without a filter, and that is what's sort of endearing about me in general. And I think when you take that away, I'm just another girl who doesn't have much of a personality. Like, just being nice isn't really a personality trait that I find interesting. Anybody can be nice. For me, the final words I say at Tribal, it's a chance for me to be me. Right before I was voted out, I was unable to really let them have it. I would like to say the things that I wish I could have said if I wasn't on the chopping block.